Welcome to the Grace Cup Ministry. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be here today.
Praise God.
And today we have Sister Florence Hudson from Cleveland, Ohio. Welcome. Apostle Celestia Gibson from Cleveland, Ohio. And she is our messenger for today. And now let us pray the Reverend Ella McDonald.
Let us pray. Father God, as again we come, we thank you for this day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes, yes.
We thank you for grace and mercy today.
Thank you
for your son, Jesus, who gave his life on Calvary Cross for our salvation. We thank you for salvation today. Father God, we come in the name of Jesus. We ask you to touch today in a mighty way. Touch this program as it go out, oh God, that somebody might hear a word from you. And, oh God, that they may give their lives to you.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for what you're doing in our lives. We thank you
thank
for what
you.
You're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Father, we ask you to bless those that are sick and afflicted,
yes.
those that are calling on your name right now. We ask you to bring healing and deliverance. And, oh God, we ask you to bless the woman of God that's going to bring the message today, oh God, that somebody might hear a word and say, I yield, and, Lord, I give my life to you. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for what you're going to do. In the very precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and thank God. Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And the Bible says men ought to always pray.
Hallelujah.
Now let's turn to our scripture, Ephesians 2, beginning with the 7th verse. And we're going to go down to 10. It says that in the ages to come, he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
For by grace are ye saved through faith, mm-hmm. and that not of yourselves.
Mm-hmm.
It is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship,
mm-hmm.
created in Christ Jesus unto good works,
yes.
which God hath before ordained for we should walk in them. Grace, his mercy, it's a free gift. God bless you. And now we will have a song by Tina Turner, and following the song, a Celestia Gibson. God bless you.
Couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low. still couldn't find nobody, nobody great, nobody great, nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried out redemption's plan. You are he who carried out redemption's plan. Couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody great, nobody great, nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. High and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody great, nobody great, nobody greater than you. 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 Nobody great, nobody great, nobody greater than you.
It is a blessing to be here today, to stand before you and give a word that the Lord has given me for such a time as this. Over the last month or so, I've been hearing the Lord talk to me about a specific thing. And I want to share a familiar scripture that many have heard, and I want to share a few words from that scripture. That scripture is found in Proverbs, the third chapter, and I will be reading about 11 verses. In this scripture, in the book of Proverbs, it says, "To everything there is a season, a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which was planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. The scripture says, what profit hath he that worketh in that wherein he laboreth? I have seen the travail which God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in it. He hath made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has set the world in their heart so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end. And so I would just like to share with you for a few moments about the importance of time. Each one of us sometimes have many busy schedules. We have things that we're preparing to do from the time we wake up until the time we rest. Oftentimes, the majority of us, we have a watch on that we look at from time to time. We look at this watch because we want to see exactly what time it is and if that time is in agreement or accordance to what we have left to do. But the Lord has been talking to me about the fact that there is great importance in this hour about the time that we have before us. He's been saying that we need to understand that there has been proportioned a time for everything that we want to get done or everything that comes in our life. There has been time set aside for that. Many of us are going to have to understand that we must be in season with the time that God has given us. Just as it has said in the first verse of Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, it says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. Many times we find ourselves out of sync with the time that God has given us and the purposes that he has given us for. And so we find ourselves doing things over here at a certain time that should be done over here. We find ourselves, as the scripture says, there's a time to weep and a time to laugh. We find ourselves sometimes out of sync when we should laugh and when we should cry. Sometimes we find ourselves out of sync with the way it says that a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones, a time to get and a time to lose. And so what is happening in our lives today is that we find ourselves a little disboggled and we don't understand why things are not going the way that we want them to go in our lives. And I've been hearing him say to me that it's because we're out of sync with the time that he has given us for what he wants us to do. Many of us have lived our lives in such a way that we find that many times we have not accomplished the things that we have wanted to do. But I'm also hearing God say, but he is still giving us time to get some things done. And it is important that we do not find ourselves moving left and right, but moving straight ahead and indecisive about what we should do. I talk to people from time to time, and they often say, I'm not sure what I should be doing right now, or I'm not sure what God is saying to me right now, or I'm not sure what season I'm in. We are leaving one season, and we have just walked into a new season. We have just left mainly the season of summer, and we're getting ready and we're preparing to go into the fall, which means that between those two seasons, there are changes that come, and we must get ready for the change from one season to another. When we look at our scenery, we can see that the leaves are turning different colors, the grass is turning different colors, that the area, the weather seems to be changing because the times of the seasons are changing. But we must know the timing of God that he has given us. Some of us, as young people, don't seem to understand the importance that they must get certain things done. Those of us who are much older can look back and say, I wished I would have done this at that time, and I wished I wouldn't have been able to get done at this time. But I'm learning that as long as God is extending you the time to get something done, that if it's all possible, that you should be working toward getting it done. I often think, even for myself, that even though I graduated many years ago, it came in my heart again that I desire to go back to school and get my degree. So about 3 years ago, I re-enrolled into college and I completed my degree the earlier part of this year. But then I felt within myself that, Lord, I wanted to continue on because there was even more that I wanted to do. So I didn't just stop there. I continued to go get another degree. And I realized that God had given me time, that even though it appeared that I had wasted many years accomplishing something that I so desired to do, He has given me time to go back and get it done. And I am grateful for the opportunity to get that time. Every day I'm hearing different things. And I know that for the majority of us, we desire to do certain things. And it is important that those desires in our heart be met. And the Bible says that if I would delight myself in the Lord, He would give me the desires of my heart. And it was my desire to go back to school, and He did just that. Now, there may be somebody who is listening that have felt in your heart that there are certain things that you have desired to do. And you have been seeking God and you have been praying and asking that these things would be done. But I'm here to give you a word today that the Lord said that there is great importance in your timing. That if it is in all possible, which we know it is, that you should be working toward meeting every need and everything that you feel that you want to do. Even as we move to do certain things, it appears sometimes there is obstacles in our way. But we know that with God, all things are possible. And anything that we desire to do, God can give us the strength to do it. And yes, even at this time in my life, I'm grateful that I have a mind and still have a mind by the grace of God that I can still study and learn. And you know, we never get too old to learn something. So it could be that somebody who is observing or listening today have desired to go back and finish their school work, something, their degree or something, their trade or something they want to do. Then there are many times that there are many people who have decided they wanted to do some special work. And it seems like time is running out. But I'm here to tell you that God still wants you to have the desires of your heart. In this scripture, as we continue to read, it says that He hath made everything beautiful in its time. When we look at everything that God has made, it is beautiful. It is beautiful just to be able to wake up in the morning and see the sunshine. It's even beautiful to wake up and be able to see the clouds or hear the rain, or even when the winter comes, see the snow. It's just a blessing that we are able to do that in those seasons and in those times. It is important. I cannot stress it enough. It is important that just as we take time to look at our watch to see what time it is important that we see that time is ticking away, little bit by little bit. When we wake up in the morning, no matter what time it is, whether it's 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock in the morning or earlier than that, before we know it, it's noon. Before we know it, it's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Before we know it, it is midnight and the day has already gone by. So time is ticking away just like a clock upon the wall. It's just going from one degree to the next. But I want to encourage someone, and I want someone to really think on this. What is your desire? What have you desired to do? Is the clock ticking to the point that you think that you cannot get it done? I want to encourage someone today that time is of essence, but yet there is still time to get done what God would have you to do. Maybe God has been speaking to someone about something specifically, and you think that there's just no way you can get it done. Or you may think that time is against you. Time is not against you at this moment if you make up in your mind to move as you feel you should do. It is a blessing. It is a blessing to be able to accomplish the things that you felt you would never be able to do. And it is a blessing, and you just have to thank God that He allowed you to see another day to accomplish that which you so desperately want to do. I think that one of the greatest blessings that God has given us is time. And sometimes we just don't see the importance of it. Sometimes we just don't want to move. Sometimes we waste days doing absolutely nothing. But I believe that God has called us all to do something. And I believe that He has given us the time to get it done. And I believe that even now, there could be things before you that you're saying, that's interesting. I've been thinking about that. I've been desiring to do that. I'm here to tell you, you can get it done. You can be a blessing in someone else's life. That's another thing that I hear God saying. What He has told us to do, and when He tells us to do it, and the purpose of what it is to be done, can affect somebody else's life. And somebody could be waiting on you to get in your place to do a certain thing so that they can accomplish what it is that they need to accomplish. We are here to be vessels unto the will of the Father. We are here for God to use us for His glory. Time is ticking away. What is it that you sense you need to do? The Bible says again, to everything, there is a season, a time to every purpose under the heaven. There is a time for everything to get done. What is it that God is saying to you today? I hope and I pray that there is something that has come to your mind or something that is in your heart that will not deter you or cause you to delay any longer. When we're on a trip, when we plan to go on a trip, we have a destination of time. When I've flown on an airplane, when I get my make my plans and I have a boarding ticket, it shows the time that I'm to leave. It shows the time to my next destination, whether it be a stop off or a layover. It shows how long I'm supposed to be there. And then it shows when I'm supposed to board my next flight. And it shows when I get to my destination. Sometimes at the airport, when we get from one place to another, we find out there is a delay. And we say, oh, I'm not going to reach my destination on time. Or we say, oh, I don't know what's going to happen. But I'm here to tell you, even in the delay, God could be speaking to us about time. Even when we're delayed from getting from one point to the other, we can learn something in the delay. And sometime in the delay, it's supposed to be a specific reason why we are in the delay. But I'm here to tell you, whether it is a delay or whether it's a postponement or whether it's a detour, you still have the opportunity to accomplish what God would have you accomplish. I want to say one more time. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under the sun. I want you to know, whatever God is telling you to do, whatever you desire to do, God wants to bless you with the time to get it done. God bless you.